poke hit and run swaps to Kolo are working quite effectively for Noble, and deeper into dampening, Kolo is not going to have that luxury to recover. But Greki gets caught in a Hammer of Justice. Now he has no trigger for a stun. Potentially Jamili is just taking so much damage. Mortal Coil, Thugonomics is moving in. Any damage can easily close.
Yeah, and now we see Cubsy is actually going to be the one in trouble because Sidri's on stun. They are, there it is. Full leg sweep onto Cubsy. Let's see, do they have the damage? Followed up by the Fist of Fury stun. Cubsy, dangerously low, gets kicked on cast, and he's going to go down. Do we have a cross kick situation, though? Trill's going to use, Shanley's going to use a touch of karma onto Sidri. Sidri dropping dangerously low, he's trying to kite. He's trying to survive here, but right now we do see Trill and Mez are just playing goalkeeper, and I think that Sidri should be fine for now.
Yes, he has no mana. Jumps in the middle of the map, but Chanimal is under too much fire. Trill's going to take him out.
At his disposal, and at this point, Mez is going to have a difficult time closing that gap to Cubsy. And now we're going to see him go after Chun-Li. Here we go. Big, big damage. Asphyxiate. Nice paralyze onto Cubsy. He's going to break, though, as that Spirit Link totem gets dropped.
Although that was a good punish by Method Orange in adapting to Cubsy's defensive kiting pattern to switch to Chun-Li. Chun-Li now needs to be more careful. He could be swapped back to later on. There's a 16-second window. In the meantime, though, Cubsy is still getting gunned down. Chun-Li with a double Fist of Fury. Trill dipping dangerously low with no trinket. Will he survive? Karma saves him. Fear on CD from Chanimal. Mez dips dangerously low as the entire team is almost in an unrecoverable position. CD has no big healing cooldowns to restabilize. Spirit Link will redistribute the health, not heal it. And with the Warlock triple dotting, it will be difficult. They drop Spirit Link, but I'm not sure if it's going to do too much. They're still a minute and 40 away from any cooldowns that could save them. Triple stun from Chun-Li. Hex into full fear. Great crowd control from Super Frogs as they launch an attack back onto Trill, finding a win on game number two.
Bottom side of the map and kind of running in a circle, which is going to make it a lot easier for Chanimal to help him out.
Yeah, but right now the pressure is mounting. Cubsy is trying to deflect with an Ascendant's Earthen Shield Totem. Will that be enough defense? In the meantime, Chanimal secured a fear on Sidu, putting him out of line of sight of his Death Knight Mez. Sidu jumping back into the fight, but stacking up for a triple stun, a critical mistake that Chun-Li looks to punish. Huge payoff. They get the Spirit Link Totem and Ascendants from Sidu. Cubsy now repositioning. He needs to use that gateway as soon as possible. He's running out a bit of time here. Chanimal might need to move in for a potential Spirit Link Totem. Cubsy fake cast the Mind Freeze, drops the Spirit Link, but Chanimal isn't there. He's just seconds away from it. Cubsy manages to stabilize. They don't actually kill the Spirit Link Totem instantly. A bit of a mistake there from Method Orange, but ultimately catching Cubsy into a full duration stun. Chanimal unending resolve to spam fear, but it may not be enough as Cubsy has nothing left. Method Orange close in all three members. Cubsy tries to jump to safety, but gripped right back into the fight and does not get interrupted. Mez has a free ride back to Cubsy. No snare's going to be hitting him. Cubsy getting silenced on the hill. On the heel, a lot of interrupts still potentially available. He needs to deal with them. Gets windsheared by Sidu. Will that be enough to close the game? No, Cubsy denies it. Double leg sweep. Cooldown traded up from Mez and Trill, though, very preemptively, which could be a punish later on.
Yeah, and I mean, at this point, Super Frogs just need to survive as long as possible. They need to keep Cubsy alive, and Cubsy's doing a great job. Now he's on Stun the Art, and he's going to get a pre-Astral Shift on that Touch of Death stun lock combo right there. That could have been very scary if he didn't do that. And actually, it still is. Cubsy's dropping dangerously low. He's going to have to trade out the Spirit Link Totem, and now Cubsy has no more defensives, which means that the next time Cubsy gets caught up like that, he's going to be in big trouble. We see a full fear on the Sidu. A lot of damage coming in.
Hex! Trail,
but that beautiful Hex is going to follow it up. Is he gonna survive? He's got, oh my god, he gets spell locked and he just gets taken down the team. But now Super Frogs have a clear win condition as we see Cubsy drop dangerously low, but he is gonna stabilize with that Hellstone, with that Ascendance.
Yeah, Cubsy needs to stay alive a little bit longer. Sidu has no Spirit Link Totem, no Touch of Karma. Trill could easily fall. What is Trill gonna do? Is he gonna keep all inning? It looks like he's going to. He's got nothing left to survive. He's caught into the leg sweep. Any crowd control on Sidu could close this out. Fists of Fury. Chanimal looking to potentially line up a fear, just focusing on getting damage. Fear being cast on Mez. Dispel on the dots by Sidu. Trill trying to set up for a kill on Cubsy, but he's still got Spirit Link Totem sitting in his back pocket for an instant recovery. Sidu dropping that Earthen Shield Totem, trying desperately to keep Trill aggressive. They need to pull the Spirit Link Totem from Cubsy soon. They're running on the clock. Trill portaling back, but Sidu caught into a fear. If Chun-Li connects, Trill will surely go down. Fist of Fury flying everyone in crowd control. Trill is flying Servant Kick, but Drain Soul will connect the kill. And I actually can't believe it. Super Frogs, with this unconventional composition, are going to do it. Advancing to the grand finals for a rematch. We can deal with it. Sidu at the same time, possible throw here, has to use the Divine Shield. This is massively in favor of the move. I do not think that Method Orange were expecting to be this far behind this early on.
Yeah, Peekaboo and WizKey really exploiting the fact that CDU's all alone. Mez and Trill nowhere to be found. Nice double fear coming in from WizKey. CDU trinkets out of the stun. Not really too much left. First Darkness going to be dropped out. That's a huge deal for Method Orange. They don't have bubble. They don't have trinket. They don't have one Darkness. One Darkness is the only thing that's going to be keeping CDU alive as this game progresses.
Yeah, and he needs to be on top of his Demon Hunters to get that. That's why we see him just YOLOing in. But he's caught a stun. He pops it. He gets into it. Will he get unlucky, though, is the question. He gets mind control to try and deny the darkness and die to dots by WizKey, but Imprison denies that. Cedar just can't recover. The pressure is way too much for him to handle in this first game, and I think he's ultimately going to be going down during this silence. He is going to fall after it gets Void Swapped. Health Exchange. Mind trading his Ascendance, but still getting crushed. They're just mashing the Purge onto Absurge, landing a Spear Hand Strike onto the heel. Absurge, though, smartly used his defensive wall before going for a cast and getting interrupted. Now, Cedar caught into a Kidney Shot with no Trinket. Anti-Magic Zone. Grip on the jump. Absurge in trouble. He drops the Link. They managed to get into it in time. They still have the Void Swap. Cedar is still low. They have to use the Void Swap as well. They can even switch. They're not going to do it. It's just healer race start to finish, and Absurge is the one immensely behind in game number two. Almost unrecoverable. He's desperately trying to jump to safety. Mez Icebound Fortitude's out of the stun. It's all in. Start to finish. Absurge gets kicked. Trill gets mind controlled away at the final second. Absurge has to fake cast a Mind Freeze. Manages to sneak in a Healing Wave. Goes for another. Manages to get it, but the damage is just too much. He's starting to cave as he falls in Method Orange. Onslaught. Cedar fake casting the Mind Freeze. Desperately trying to heal through this. No, actually did not fake cast it. Now getting interrupted. Jumping away from the waterfall. Death Grip, though, immediately on the jump. Kidney Shot to follow up. Forcing a Trinket. Silence onto the Trinket. Pressure is still mounting. Frost Dragon not really going to accomplish too much into that shield wall, though, and he's not going to have to worry about that threat. Bit of a misplay there from WizKey. Absurge now falling behind as Method Orange lead in. The Spirit Link Totem is the last line of defense, but he's silenced up on 10%. Barely connects it in time.
Yeah, Cedu's the one that's in trouble now. Cheap shot on him. He still has the Spirit Link Totem. Doesn't want to get greedy. Getting lower and lower. No one there for the Spirit Link. Finally, Trill and Mez come back. All three members get the Spirit Link. But look at Absurge. He is so far gone. He doesn't want anything to do with this. Cedu now getting interrupted. Nice shot. Out of step kick coming in from Peekaboo as Cedu rots lower and lower. WizKey looking to connect as well and close out this game. Can Cedu survive any longer? In the meantime, though, Absurge also taking a whole bunch of damage. This is going to be a cross kill more than likely. Can Absurge hold on just a little bit longer?
He
fakes it. Gets taken down 2v2.
All right. Mez and Trill both have defensive cooldowns and Peekaboo does not. So Peekaboo is going to be at a disadvantage. Mez trades out. Peekaboo can't get away from the pressures. Method Orange are going to clean him up. WizKey has the Pillar of Frost activated. He has a huge boost of damage. He could take down Mez, potentially taking this to a 1v1. Mez in trouble, desperately using Corpse Shield and Death Strike to stabilize and stay alive long enough for Trill to finish the job, and they do.
Totem. Perhaps the move are actually going to go on a different target. Maybe blind Trill to bait his Trinket and then go on him. They open with Cheap Shot Garrote, though, on Cedu. Kidney Shot, Pillar of Frost. Tons of damage that they have. Go for an all-in. Cedu is playing it greedy, and he gets... Okay,
Cedu. That's fine. Just give me a heart attack. He's literally, his health disappeared, but he survives. It was a greedy decision to not commit the Trinket earlier, but he ultimately makes it out alive, but the momentum is still in favor of the move.
Yeah, but how much longer can Cedu live? He has no Trinket, no Astral Shift, no nothing if the next Kidney Shot connects on him, and there it is, if they can connect this damage, but a pre-Earthen Shield Totem by Cedu is going to keep him along live enough to sort of deflect a lot of this damage. But look at Absurge, still has the wall, still has the Spirit Link Totem. He's doing quite fine. Cedu, in the meantime, in a lot of trouble.
I mean, there's nothing left for him. I really don't think he can do much. Absurge does Astral Shift, he gets gripped back, but blind on Trill. This time, WizKey not breaking that blind. And that should be more than enough, potentially, for Absurge to survive. They still have defensives. They could take the 2v3, but Trill's getting controlled quite a lot. Absurge is creating distance, but Windwalker can close that gap. Mez not trading defensives, kind of just giving up. There's the surrender from Mez. Uses it immediately. Absurge actually switched to Trinket, so he can Trinket Spirit Link. I think that was a smart decision. There's the disarm, but it's a little bit too late. The all-in is basically botched, and now WizKey can have free reign, and Cedu could be in trouble if he's not able to get away.
Yeah, he leaps away, but gets gripped back immediately by WizKey. Cedu's still in a lot of trouble. Uses the Astral Shift, uses the Ascendance to sort of stabilize that all-in. All-in talents Mez has are starting to fade. WizKey, though, still getting low. Spirit Link available for both Shamans as they both get traded out. This is such a close game.
Yeah, I mean, WizKey's the one that's still so far behind. Cedu who's comfortably sitting out of crowd control, and WizKid could ultimately die. He's hanging on at 10%. Abstract barely connects the heal. Defensive blind on Trill, punishing that relentless pick to deny and execute on WizKid. WizKid's got one more opportunity. He's got Pillar of Frost in 12 seconds.
Uh-oh.
If he can make it to that point, CDU in trouble, though. Caught into the kidney shot as the move looked to close this. He's hanging on at 10%. Is he going to be able to do it? Disarm on WizKid, trying to stall it out, but it's not enough. WizKid is still in trouble. If there's an imprison for Abstract or a kick on the heal, it doesn't seem like there is the interrupts available. Mez now going to ultimately be going down.
I guarantee that Super Rejects are going to be losing this. At this point, take out your friendly bets at what dampening this is ultimately going to get up to. Chanimal, the nice Capacitator Totem from Cubsy, allowing Chanimal to free cast. He got a lot of unstable afflictions. Chun-Li disabling Smexen on his jump to get more uptime. He's desperately trying to force an astral shift. Kolo sitting on Cubsy to deny the drink, and he seems like he will be able to, but now he's left Chanimal open, and Chanimal is not a warlock that you want to leave open for too long.
Yeah, Kolo caught into the full fear. Chanimal's just throwing out the UAs over and over and over. I think he got three or four off there. Full bash on Chun-Li, kick on Cubsy. Little bit of pressure here for Super Rejects as we do move forward to 25% dampening. Gouge now on Cubsy. He pops his Ascendants, trying to top off his entire team. Chun-Li deep in enemy territory right now. He's going to be coming back, making a retreat, trying to get some damage over on a Kolo. Manages to land the Fist of Fury.
Touch of death.
Touch of death as well. Can they take Kolo down? Leg sweep. Do they have the CC on Envious? No.